Hey everyone, Dave here from SonicOrbStudios, and the car has turned into a project. It's a 2011 Hyundai Sonata GLS with the 2.4 liter, I think GDI or something like that, the crazy fuel injector system. Either way, I've been ripping out interior. I did both door panels, put some sound deadening material in the front doors. Got a little bit in the back doors, but I couldn't get the windows unattached from the regulator. And so I decided to just get to what I could there and work on it. But today we are ripping out the interior. I've got some RCA cable, which is this twisted pair here from New Concepts, and the blue power lead for switched power. And that's running back to a cheapo little sub in the back seats from Walmart. You know, the typical cheap one for like 80 bucks or 50 bucks or whatever it is that everyone tries and says it's decent, but probably not decent at all. For me, I just need some lower end. I'm not looking for anything amazing, just something that could, you know, move a little bit more than the 6.5-inch speakers in the doors and stop a bunch of rattling. But anyway, let's start putting things back together. By the way, getting these pins out of here, kind of a pain in the butt, honestly, because of some of the, I guess, the stress of the dashboard open glove box dealio, just on the pins. But you gotta pinch the pins and then slide them out towards the center on each one. That took the longest, I think, out of anything. These side panels you get from like back here, you pop them straight up, and then you pull them outward towards the rear of the car. And there's two screws on each corner here, one on each corner actually, and then two screws on each side of the radio, and that pops out with like three or four different, probably six leads in total. And I'm not sure what this is, if it's an airbag. It looks like just, you know, fiberglass insulation and the whatnot. But we're gonna fix some rattling points in the doors after all this is done too, I'm sure. But I figured I'd start documenting a little bit of this. Eventually, I'm going to pull out the full interior, get the center console out of here, probably in a few weeks. And we're going to put sound deadening in the whole floor of the vehicle, specifically starting from the front, just quieting things down. Doing the door panels and the roof has already fixed quite a bit. But I want to get all on the flooring done to cut down a lot more noise. But we're going to see what we're going to put in the center console. It's going to be a double din for sure. I think I'm going to go boss. But I think the last car I did, I know I did a Pioneer in that. And that thing sounded amazing. But the reason for having a factory replacement head end on here is to be able to adjust your crossovers and do more processing than you would with just the factory radio. So it should get better sound with that. We're going to swap speakers in the doors. And a whole project is probably going to cost about $350 in the end. So not terribly bad. And that's just electronics. I mean, the sound deadening, I think it's about, you know, $50 or so for each box. And I ordered two boxes of that. So, it's a little bit costly, but not terribly bad considering, like, I can go to a shop and probably spend about $1,000 to do probably all the same that I'm doing here. And, you know, me, I love to do all this stuff myself. Anyway, touch base with you a few times while we put this back together. So as an update, I got the glove box back in, and there was a side panel here that I put back on. Got the trim piece there back on. The wires had to be run down past the B pillar and then back into the subwoofer, wired in. What I did up here was the power lead, blue wire that comes with most amp wiring kits, and generally you just get a blue wire. Taps into this. This is the main power. I believe this is all audio on this connector here. But on the back of this, you can see like your main power wires, and then right next to it is that blue wire. That's generally, and usually blue, is your switched power. So we tapped into that. I just stripped it a little bit back with my wire strippers, soldered on the connection, and taped it all up nicely with some, I think, Super 33 or 77 Sketch brand tape. The electrical tape, Jeff. And that's run back here, nicely zip tied with everything. We got the RCA lead sort of just tucked behind the dashboard for now. And now we're just going to plug things back in and be good with it on the front end, reassemble that. Radio's back on there. What I want to show you guys, though, is the center trim piece. When you're pulling it out, there's a screw here, one on each side, and you pop it out. So if I flip it over, you can sort of see the clip points. So a clip here, and then one at the top, sort of a smaller clip, and then one up here. And I think the ones towards the top, they don't even, they go into like plastic clip dealios. Actually, there should be one of those on the other side. I see it on the dashboard now, so I'm going to pull it off, get it on there, and then we'll pop this into place. So just be aware of like where your clip points are. There's one up here, one down there, and the screw at the bottom, and of course, towards the top here. So be gentle with it, pull it straight outward. It's about 1, 2, 3 wires to plug into this, and you'd be good to go. So we got all the trim pieces just back on minutes ago, at least. I did, you guys didn't, so we didn't. But that was fun. These side pillars, you'll break all the clips in the bottom of these, except the little double clips at the bottom. All the metal ones that are held in by plastic, expect to break those. You might want to invest in finding a source. But either way, they seem to hold on, even without, like, most of them still clipping in place. Here's the freaking amplifier, this little woofer back here. We will be wiring 8 gauge to, I believe it's double 16 gauge. It's oddly small wire. And I would like to see terminal blocks on such an amp, but we're going to have to use wire nuts or some sort of terminal block external dealio. I might have to, try to find a way to add a terminal block or something to this in the future, but yeah, it's a small little cheapo setup. Got the remote switch lead. That's going to be wired to the blue. We've got these two are supposed to be for audio. We got to run a head end unit before we plug this in, though. For now, the RCA cables are sort of tucked in here, and I'm going to leave them all along because the eventual goal is to put a new amplifier and processing unit all in the back. It's going to be like, I think, a 4 or 5 channel amp in the back with some digital processing by a certain company. But we'll cover that when we have more money and funding for the project and at a later date. And I'll bring you guys along for all that too. But the sort of setup here is to run as much wiring, at least to here, and then have slack on it so we can run it into the trunk, where on a side panel here, we've got between the sort of material and whatnot, we can run all the gear and mount amplifiers and processing units there for better, clarity and sound. I'm not going for a freaking monster bass unit here. I'm just going for more clarity, a little bit more low end to help take away from the mid-end punch, not have to rattle my doors as much. But this little sub, I think, will do the trick a little bit. And it fits nicely in the back of my service vehicle. So, yeah, gets wiring things up here. Nah, I don't think we're going to be able to test anytime soon until we get the head end unit in.